We are on. We are live.
Good morning, dear friends. I'm here joined live by my good friend, the shaman and spiritual teacher, Northern Deer Alexander.
Hello,
And
dear friend.
I wanted to, in these challenging times that we are all experiencing at the moment with the virus and the panic about the virus, I wanted to speak with you, Alexander, and have your wisdom and your opinion about these things from obviously a spiritual point of view or a shamanic point of view.
Thank you very much, my friend, for this invitation. I also wanted to talk with you, and because first of all, we need to talk about what is happening and not keep everything in our head, in our mind, because the mind, when it is under the spirit of fear, it creates crazed images, images of fear, and then we have a tendency to believe in what we are thinking, and also believe also in the negative news that we hear. The people who have this tendency, they hear the negative news, they believe it, and then, there is this reticular activating system that will search automatically to match and find the same negative information and
Amplified,
amplify it, represent it everywhere, and regenerate it. And this is like destructive for the psyche, for the health, for everything. We have to avoid this and actually listen to the more wise advice and remain, of course, always conscious, aware, and calm. Even in the middle of the storm, you have to be calm.
Reminds me, that's actually, I post a quote every day, and today's quote was exactly that. It was by Deepak Chopra that amongst the busyness and the chaos around you, keep stillness inside you. So,
Absolutely.
and there was a video by Eckhart Tolle, which I told you about earlier that I
Yes.
posted yesterday. So I will direct people to seek the opinions of people who have a very different point of view and not the media that will
Yes.
only promote the fear and
Yes.
intensify those fearful
Yes.
thoughts that people have.
Yes. Now, if it is one moment in your life to listen to some spiritual teacher who is real and good, this is the right moment, because who you would like to be your leader, let's say, in the most difficult period? Somebody who is right in the absolute sense, and he is like seeing the more elevated point of view and the more true point of view, not the chaotic external circumstances. Yes.
I wanted to ask you your point of view from the shamanism point of view or a spiritual point of view,
Yes.
both actually. And one question I wanted to ask is Mother Earth punishing us for what we've been doing to her?
No, of course, it's not punishing. Nobody's punishing us. Because there is nobody like a person. Yes. If you would jump from the third floor and you break your legs in the earth is punishing you.
No, of course not.
Course not. Of course, it's like you cannot even say that you punish yourself, because you don't do it on purpose. But the fact is that you are punished. But you are not really punished, you just receive the consequence of your actions.
Cause and effect.
Cause and effect, exactly. So this is happening, of course. What is happening is the effect of some cause.
I understand. Yes, the word punishing was wrong. So
Yeah,
yeah, it
well,
is.
yeah, symbolically you can call it like this if
Sure.
it helps you. But I don't think it helps us to see this as a punishment. From the point of view of shamanism, there is a very good explanation, not so much about what is happening in generally, but to understand what you have to do, how to remain healthy, how to be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
For example, in shamanism, it is very known that for everything in your life, you need to have what is called in shamanism, the kut. It is this word kut. Kut means the vital power or the vital energy or the personal power. It has mm-hmm. this kind of different names. In Siberia, it's called kut. It is like the spirit, the essence of the earth life. So the life on the earth is created by the energy of the sun, and it gives us this kind of aliveness, this kind of desire to live, desire to act, desire to do whatever, to be active in the life. This is what motivates humans and every alive being.
Mm-hmm.
While you are with a physical body on the earth, you are motivated by the energy of the sun to act, to do some things. Your body and your energy system has this energy of the sun, which is your life force that moves you. Yes. So now many things depend on this. This is more like the battery of a toy. You know, there are some toys that need a battery, or your cell phone needs a battery.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. When this battery is weakened, then the toy is malfunctioning. It doesn't have enough energy. So you will see the toy moving, but it's moving like in a hectic way. It's not really moving well.
Yeah.
Stopping moving, and some things are not working at all. If it is these old electronic games, you remember, with some joysticks, when the battery was finishing, they start blipping. It was not, then it will stop, then it will appear again, and you would lose something.
Mm. Is our battery running out then?
Yes, yes. So when your battery is running out, or it's not very charged,
yeah,
you are not functioning in the optimal level. Okay, so when you are not functioning in the optimal level, you are prone to diseases. You are susceptible to influences and diseases also.
Mm-hmm.
Then coronavirus can catch you and influence you. And this is why the people who are actually who have died are the people who were more sensitive. Like the older people, the people who had already some diseases,
mm-hmm.
which was the result of their lowered vital energy. Because when the disease comes, you have to fight it. Your body will fight it, right? And if you don't have enough battery to sustain this fight, eventually your battery finishes completely. It's drained. And when your battery is drained, you are out of here.
Mm-hmm.
That's when you die, actually, mm-hmm. when you don't have enough. So your body gives up and the virus takes over and kills you. Understand? So everything depends on the vital energy. Now, the vital energy depends on other things. It's not like something with a battery to put it and recharge or something like that. It depends on your lifestyle, on your mind, on the level of your awareness, because the way that your mind works, the way that your emotions works, mm-hmm. the way that your body works and your actions depend on the level of your consciousness. For example, if you will allow the negativity to seep in and take over you, then you cannot have negative thoughts, negative feelings, but a lot of energy.
Mm-hmm.
You will start feeling depressed and you are going to be influenced into negativity. So the immune system is shutting down, is weakened. So you need to try to make effort to keep yourself positive.
Mm-hmm.
Work with yourself in the sense to be sincere. Mm-hmm. As Eckhart Tolle says in his video, that you will put the link, you need to build now your house in a very strong foundation. Yes, and actually, if your house already is not in a strong foundation, you need to check now. It's now the moment to check your house. And if you see that your house has some weaknesses, you need to start reconstruction and sustainability work
mm-hmm.
to change some things. Now it is the moment to actually be sincere with yourself. Because the most difficult thing to do in this world, according to shamanic knowledge and the spiritual knowledge, is to be sincere with yourself first of all. And usually we want to do this, but we are avoiding it in the end. Or we rationalize our weaknesses or our wrong parts in order to appear good or different in our eyes, to in front of our eyes, in order to not feel bad about ourselves, to not feel our traumas. Because when you start feeling bad about yourself, also your traumas from childhood start surfacing, and we don't want this. So we rationalize all the time, we excuse ourselves, we blind ourselves, and it's difficult to be sincere. But now it is the moment actually to start becoming sincere. You don't have to judge yourself negatively. This does not mean to be sincere, but to simply see what you know that you have to do, what you know you are doing wrong. You know some things, and these things, to maybe you cannot immediately change them in one day, in one second, but you have to see them for what it is, and then try to find the best strategy or method to work with yourself.
Yeah,
that will save you.
Seeing ourselves objectively, which can be difficult. Can I ask you? You said earlier about the metaphor or the analogy of the battery as our vital energy, which gets drained with negativity, etc. What kind of advice or ways would you suggest to people to start replenishing their vital energy? You mentioned some things already, but if someone were to ask you, so how can I fortify myself and get more vital so that I can fight the virus or better, what would you say?
Very good question. There are many things. I will tell you from many points of view, and everybody can take from this what he can utilize. For me, the most important of all is, until this moment, to have realized what is your actual purpose in your life. To have a real self-realized purpose. What does this mean and why? Because when you have a purpose, the purpose, of course, is something positive. And if this purpose is the purpose of your life, then anything else is secondary. If it is the purpose of your life, it means this is like the most important for you, for your life. So the first thing you have to do is to not lose this. For example, if now a disease comes and you start forgetting your life's purpose, you are going to be disconnected from the big source of energy for you. Now somebody may think, yes, but what if my life purpose was to go right, let's say, to one direction, but now because of the disease I have to go left, I have to now stop everything else. So I have two answers about this. First, it may mean that it was not the real purpose for you, because if it is the real purpose, nothing should stop it, even disease. For example, let's say if your an example, if your real purpose was to have a happy family, let's say, a disease should stop happiness and you start having like a suffering family. No, you have to sustain somehow your spirit and the joy and the good condition and the happiness in your home. Okay, it does not matter if somebody is sick. If sickness will destroy your psychology, then you are missing on your goal, which was to create a happy family and a happy union within yourself. If yourself was, if your purpose was self-realization, for example, a spiritual purpose, a disease could not stop you. Say, now I cannot, let's say, meet my true self because now I'm sick. I have to take care of my health. Then it means health is disconnected from yourself. So it takes you somewhere else. So it was not the real path then, because in the real path you have to connect everything that life has. So, or this, it is the meaning, or if it is another option, is maybe your life task is to become healthy. Now that the disease comes and knocks your door and you become aware of the health issues, maybe this you were neglecting this. And it is a very important part, your survival, of course. then you have, if this takes your attention, then you have to put all your attention, but not in the sense to be scared of the virus, mm-hmm. but in the sense that, okay, I have now to fix my house to be based on the right foundation. So I have to, once and for all, fix the health issues. So no matter what, I will be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
So you, then you check yourself, what is your lifestyle, what you're doing wrong, and where you lose your vital energy. And where we lose our vital energy? In the most simple level, it is food. So if you eat junk food, for example, junk food doesn't have vital energy.
Mm-hmm.
You need to find the food that is alive, yeah. that gives you the sense that has alive substances, right? If you eat something and it's like something like a mass of dead thing, but tasty because it has a lot of sugar or some taste,
mm-hmm.
but it doesn't give you the feeling that it is alive, like you would take something from life and it has life force in it. So you have to replace dead food with food that is giving you more life force, and you, you yeah. will feel this in your body. First. Second, to not eat a lot. Overeating is something that drains the vital energy, because the majority of people have a tendency to overeat, to eat emotionally, for emotional reasons. When you eat more than your body needs, for emotional reasons, then your body has to spend vital energy to digest the excess of food and to deal with it, to store it, and so on. Yes? So this creates problems, and you spend vital energy for a useless cause. And then yeah. the body has to store the excess mass of food into fat or other molecules, but this burdens, because you have to sustain constantly this, the body spends more energy now to sustain a mass that is useless for him,
mm-hmm.
or for it, actually.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to take care to not eat more than the right way of eating is when you finish the food to have more energy than before. Not to feel heavy and you need now to go to sleep or you need now to rest. Yeah. This means that now you need to stop external activity because now your body needs to spend energy for digestion. Mm-hmm. All the energy now goes for digestion. But if you eat the right amount, after eating, you have more vital energy and you feel that you can be more active. So the right is to eat less, small amounts, just to get energy from the food. Yes? So the quality of the food, the quantity of the food, mm-hmm. and then the physical activity. If you are lazy, for example, if you sit all day on the couch, your body gets used to inertia because vital energy is produced by the physical body if it is active. So a kind of more active lifestyle if it is necessary.
Mm-hmm.
Then psychologically, you need to be motivated to pursue some goals in your life that motivates you to pursue them, and you are excited and happy to do what you are doing. If you are dragging yourself to go to work or to meet your friends or to meet your spouse or to do anything because somehow you must do all these things but you don't want, of course this eats your vital energy, demotivates you and drains you psychologically, emotionally, and energetically. And of course, if you see something like this, you have to do something to change yourself, your life. This is the moment actually to seriously check the reality of your of yourself, of your life.
Mm-hmm.
Then there are exercises, special techniques, shamanic knowledge that you can use to strengthen your vital body directly. Because this vital energy is symbolically, it is called the element of fire in us through the knowledge of the four elements and so on.
Mm-hmm.
So the energy of fire, this element, it can grow. How it grows? When we express ourselves more freely, if you stop yourself from expressing what you want, this kills the fire inside of you. If you allow yourself more to be free in your expression, in the way you live, in the way you express yourself, then the energy starts flowing more easily. Parallel in the financial world, if you are stingy and you are afraid to invest your money to what you want, for example, to invest your money in your business, but you are afraid to spend money,
mm-hmm.
and your business will not grow. If you are freely, you see an opportunity and you freely put a flow of money to this opportunity, you have opportunities to grow. And sooner or later, your business will grow. You have to take steps forward to express yourself in a business, right? To put the business out there, to do many things, to talk with mm-hmm. your clients, with the people. Mm-hmm. The same is for everything, for your own energy.
Yeah.
And another thing, yes, is to have ideas and goals and purposes in your life that motivate you, that inspire you, that are not boring or through obligation. And all this together gives you the flow of vital energy to wake up in the morning, and you are happy to wake up and live. If you wake up in the morning and you say, oh my God, I have to wake up and to again live.
All these things, wrong.
Something is wrong. I have to do all these things to meet again my boss, to meet my spouse, and to, yeah. Oh, I don't want to wake up. Yes, you have to see something there.
Let me ask you something else about people spending lots of time at home now, because with shops and jobs being closed and the restrictions in people going out. Mm-hmm. So you told me earlier that some people will see that like a holiday, and they will just spend all that time watching TV or doing nothing productive.
Yes.
And I just wanted a quick comment from you, just because we said that earlier on off the record, but I think it's something important for people to realize how they can utilize this opportunity, because everything, in every adversity, there is an equal opportunity. And
yes.
There is this big adversity that we all face, but it has an equal opportunity, because everything is balanced in life. There's
absolutely
never bad without the good. So give us your comment on that, please.
Yes, everything in life is balanced by itself, first of all. So I will give you an example. When Bruce Lee was injured and he was incapable of moving his body at all, I mean, all his life was through his body, right? Yeah. So everything he was doing was the martial arts. He was a master of this. And then suddenly he was injured, his back. He broke, I think, his back or something.
Mm.
And he was in the hospital for months, maybe for a year. I don't remember the details, but for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Incapable of moving at all. He was like paralyzed. And he used this as a motivation to strengthen his willpower. So he said, I will make my body move again. And second, he created his own style of martial art in this period.
Yes.
Because he had the moment now to focus his mind and to see deeper in the theoretical level what he has to do.
Mm-hmm.
So he created he made a revision of all his life or all his techniques, and he created his system, and also used it, this incapacity that he had, just as an opponent in his training. Now his opponent was his own body.
Mm.
He had to win this if he has to be a warrior, because the code of the warrior is never surrender, never retreat, never quit.
Mm-hmm.
So the worst thing you can do is when the adversity hits you and takes your best thing,
yes,
to quit, to surrender, to retreat, and to mm-hmm. say, to use this as an excuse to feed the weak part of you.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, yes, I'm trying all my life to do something, but now look, this is a sign that forget everything.
Mm-hmm.
Now, why to try now to do anything? Because now nothing works. Now everything is against us. Now we're all going to die, something like that. So why not enjoy? It's like the last cigarette of before you are executed. You know, now it's only time for your desire.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not like this, because you are not going to be executed. Yes, if it would be your last second, you could spare this second, say, okay, this is my last meal. Yeah, why not enjoy the best meal? Just be lazy for 1 second after I'm dying.
Mm-hmm.
But even then, you don't want to be lazy, just your life stops. But life is not stopping. until it stops, really. You just have an opponent in front of you.
Yes.
And the worst moment to relax is when the opponent is in front of you, ready to take your head. Right? Mm-hmm. It's the moment that you have to wake up, actually, and say, oh my God, now is the moment that all the training and whatever I was doing before, now it has to kick in, and now is the moment. And you see, when it's an opponent, an aggressive opponent, you know it. But now the opponent is internal. You understand? Externally, it seems like the activity stops, but actually the moments are very intense. So you, now it is the moment to do the opposite, not to use this as an excuse. The mind will use it as an excuse. But now is the moment to really concentrate. Say, okay, this is like now a challenge. I have to wake up, to strengthen myself. Now I have to make the actual effort to not sleep. So the worst thing is now to become lazy, to stay in front of TV, to start eating junk food all day, and to become like a lazy pig. Because what else to do in the house, right? Now you have a prolonged weekend, vacation. No, it's not like this. It will be the worst thing because, let's say, even if it will last 3 months, this isolation, if you will train yourself to be lazy, after 3 months, when everything will change, you will not be able to snap out of this.
Yes.
You will
Makes
be
sense. Yeah.
Like this, and you will just continue going down.
Mm-hmm.
Understand? Why to become lazy in the first place? You don't want to be lazy. We are resting when we have done a work, and now it is the moment to rest.
Mm-hmm.
For example, if you are working, let's say, all week, hustling, yes, you can take the weekend to rest. But if you are not doing this and you have now just free time, you don't need to rest because by definition, you will not do so many things.
It is what you said that about laziness. I agree with that that term because there are so many opportunities, especially now that everyone is connected through the internet. Yes. You have opportunities to do things that you didn't have time to do before, and communicate and learn and meditate and find some things that really will help you grow, help other people. And that's one thing that I've noticed happening with the virus, the epidemic, that people seem to be more connected to each other and more willing to help each
that
other.
Very,
the,
very good,
a deeper sense of you know, human connection
that
is
very
growing.
Important. We have to focus on these things. We have to realize this thing that this is an opportunity, for example, for people to become more like brothers and sisters,
mm-hmm.
to support each other.
Yeah.
Because this will take the fear away. The fear basically is from feeling isolated in a cold world that does not care about you and you can just die and nobody cares. This is the fear that we have.
Mm-hmm.
The most easy way to disappear fear is unity between people.
And actually, this is what I wanted to ask you about next, fear.
Yes.
In general, and specifically, of course, the fear with what's going on and the fear about the future. But I would love your thoughts, your opinion on fear as what it is and what it does and how we can cope with it.
This is a very big topic.
I know it is. be as brief as you can be.
No. The most important thing to understand about fear is when the situation is real, you are never really scared. The fear that destroys us is the psychological fear when nothing happens and we are thinking about the possible negative things.
The future.
Yes. For example, you may sit in here, it is dark, and you may think, oh my God, if I go out, something may happen to me, somebody may attack me, and then you start feeling fear to go out. Mm-hmm. If you go out, then you are in the present, you will sense if there is a danger. And if there is a real danger, I mean, you see some people there or something, you go back, and you know now that you should not go out, and you're not afraid anymore. You just lock yourself there, and you may call the police or something like that.
Yeah.
And you are not anymore scared, actually. Understand? When there is an action happening, even if it is scary action, in the moment that this the action is happening, you are present. You may have adrenaline. The fear is translated into adrenaline if it's something dangerous. Understand? But the adrenaline propels you to act, or to scream, or to react, or something like that. And it is burnt through your action.
Mm-hmm.
What destroys is to sit here in this environment, nothing happens, and I consume negative information in my brain, and this creates stress without any action possible, because there is nothing really happening in reality for me to do anything about it. But I'm sitting here, I'm stressing myself, what could happen? What may happen? And of course, theoretically, something may happen to you, but because it's not connected with your reality, it's a theoretical possibility, so you cannot act upon it.
Yes.
So you're just consuming stress, and you create adrenaline, which cannot be expressed. So this destroys your brain, your physiology, and then when you're and consumes vital energy, because the energy has to metabolize the adrenaline.
Mm-hmm.
Your energy levels drop. After a while, you are tired, stressed. And when your energy levels drop, your mind starts thinking even more negatively.
Mm-hmm.
Because the way we are thinking depends also on the level of vital energy. You have more energy, you're thinking more positively automatically. You have less energy, automatically your mind tunes to the heavy negative thoughts by itself, by default. This is why if you feel bad, you cannot have good thoughts, even if you want. And if you are high, you cannot have bad thoughts, even if you want. You say, it's okay, I know I can do anything. And how you say you know? Because you feel it.
Yes.
If you feel bad, you feel bad, so you feel that you cannot do something. Because to do something positive, you need to have this kind of motivation, this kind of positive, vibrant energy in you. If you feel bad and you feel like depressed or sad or something like that, this is the result of lack of vital energy. All is the same thing, understand?
Mm-hmm.
So this is the way. And the spirit of fear is created from the mind. So when you catch yourself being influenced from the collective unconsciousness or from yourself, it doesn't matter even if something is happening to you. You have to fight with negative forces in you so that they don't take over you.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't mean you need to be positive, like, no, nothing is happening to me. I'm good and I'm healthy and... But you are in the hospital, man. Not like this, but to not allow the negativity to take over you psychologically.
Yes.
Understand? Not to lie to yourself. For example, you feel bad and you say, no, I don't feel bad. The opposite. If you feel bad, you need to recognize this. I feel bad, to accept it, and then say, okay, but this is not good for me. I have to do something to feel good. So what can I do? I have to uplift myself. So you have to meditate, or to go out, or to breathe, or to exercise, or to do something constructive. Because negativity, fear, becomes destructive.
Mm-hmm.
The antidote is to do something constructive. Okay, so you have to feel all these things, and you cannot say just positive things in your mind, like positive affirmations without feeling them also.
Sure. Sure.
So find what is constructive. The fear is the worst.
I know it is, and it is what many people suffer from, and that is what caused the immune system to drop. You explain it with the vital energy, which you said something. I made a note of it. Not to allow the negativity to take over you psychologically, because once that happens, you are going down.
Yes. In shamanic tradition, this is called you are entering in the underworld.
Mm-hmm.
And like the shamans observe all these things like spirits. For example, they say the spirit of fear. They don't say just fear. It is as if it is an entity.
Mm-hmm.
And it is a good way to see it as if it is an entity. Also in the esoteric martial arts, the warriors see this thing like an enemy. That this is like my opponent or my inner demon. You know, the warrior has to face his demons in order to be winner, to be like who he has to be.
It's a great metaphor.
Yes, this is like a good metaphor. But in reality, it is like this. Like this.
Mm-hmm.
So it is your inner demon, the fear. It is the bad spirit that wants to conquer your consciousness and to take over you. Doesn't matter how you call it. And you, this is your opponent. You have to transcend this. And you have to find the way to really do this. The best way is seek advice from wise people, like from mentors, from people who have power that you don't have in this moment. The worst thing is to complain and to try to explain how bad things are and why you are scared, to rationalize and explain to everybody, to so everybody becomes also scared like you.
Yeah.
Like to multiply this. Because the shamans will tell you that this is like the bad spirit wants to go to everyone.
Mm-hmm.
To eat the vital energy also of the others. And this is why what we are actually doing. When we feel bad, we want to say this to everyone. I feel bad and but things are bad and oh my God. And the others to feel bad for you and say, oh yes, you are right. Oh, it's terrible. And this is the way that negativity
is spreads. Yes. Mm-hmm.
So yeah. If you are aware of it, find somebody who will tell you the solution.
Mm.
The best is a mentor. Or colleagues, other friends and people who are in the same path with you of personal development, mm-hmm. or people who have some power inside of them, and they will give you some more wise advice. Follow these people. Or hang out with them. This is where they say that you have to choose your circle of people. Yes, in a circle of warriors, for example,
mm-hmm.
if one warrior starts feeling fear, they don't let him just like that. They put him in the middle and they tell him, snap out of it, man. Like, we need you. We are a community. We are like a group. We cannot have a weak link. You have to, and they are pushing him to wake up. In the tribes, they do the same. And in our circle of friends, we should do the same.
Mm-hmm.
Don't allow negativity to penetrate, seep in everyone and start multiplying. And another more practical thing, simple thing, is to keep yourself active. I mean, go to the gym, go run, do some push-ups.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's not the best solution, but if it takes over you completely the negativity and you start going crazy, just don't stay there and suffer it. Except if you can meditate upon it,
mm-hmm.
because there are some traditions that tell you, allow this and observe it, meditate, and it will go. If you can do this, yes, it will go.
It's not very easy. Like, it's easy to be sucked into it.
Yes. But if you are a yogi and you can, a meditator, and you can stay with the negativity and observe it, meditate, yes, eventually it evaporates inside your consciousness because mm-hmm. negativity cannot stay permanently. But if you cannot do this and it starts taking over you psychologically and you start reacting, mm-hmm. you have to fight it. The first thing is you have to like to not accept this thing. But this is not good for you.
Mm-hmm.
And you have or to seek advice or to becoming more active. Because when the fear takes over, you become passive and you want to close yourself and start crying and start just whining and complaining and
yes,
repeating it.
Mm-hmm. That's great. And you can also take a cold shower. That will change cold you shower. Immediately once you do that. The fear goes away, at least for a period of time.
And you know, you did the Wim Hof method.
Yeah.
Which I was doing for many years in Siberia, cold baths in minus 38 degrees in the morning.
Yeah.
After running for 1 hour in the morning, then dipping in the
better than coffee. Wakes you up.
Totally. Totally. And yeah, I mean, you cannot complain after that at all. Your energy goes like to the opposite side, and you are simply happy, and you see everything so simply. How good it is. Everything is good, actually.
Fantastic. I wanted just one last question I wanted to ask you. And so, is during these challenging times, is there anything in specific that you teach your students in your school of wisdom and spiritual adventure? Maybe we've already covered it, but is there anything else you wanted to add?
Yes. Yes, I can add many things. What we are doing is that now we intensify online meetings where we come together and we do specific trainings. We have a specific how to say, combination of practices that help us from all points of view, because you need to strengthen your body, your energy, to strengthen emotionally and mentally.
Yeah.
There are these four aspects. Okay. So for the body, we do some yoga meditations, like through the body, asana.
Yes.
For the energy, we do psychoenergetic training, psychological energetic training from the esoteric martial arts, some techniques. So that where you express yourself like more intense, something like martial arts, but without training to fight physically, but you fight with your demons energetically. Yes. Simply say you can put the sack, boxing sack, and beat your fear. Beat the crap out of your fear or something like that. Yes, and detoxify your fear like this with something very intense.
Sure.
We do also the revision of life, which is to go, and we are working with our traumas and with our memories, because all this psychological fear comes from the past. We were not born with it, but everything we learned through our education, through our upbringing. And then we do another practice, which is called lucid dreaming, which is to go and become aware of our subconscious mind, in the sense that when we dream in the night, our subconscious mind is unfolding itself. So our dreams is the unfolding of your subconscious mind. So to become more and more aware of what is happening in the dream, there are specific shamanic techniques there. And also we have an energetic field through which we are dreaming. And by training this with this energetic field and cleaning it, here I cannot say more because this is a whole training and so on. But we do a lot of energetic techniques and physical techniques. Another thing is we intensify our teachings. So what you can do in your home is like seriously take some spiritual books and study them. Not just read to get information and notes, but really study them and go deeper into yourself through this knowledge. It's a very good thing to do. Of course, watch also TV or a movie or something, but let not this be the primary thing. Especially if you start feeling that you become bored and your energy starts dropping, so it becomes more easy to continue watching TV. If you catch yourself like this, this is like bad. You need to understand that, okay, now I feel that if I will watch one more hour TV, I will feel even more like down. You need to cut this and close the TV, even if your laziness is, no, come on, what to do? I feel already tired. Come on, please let me vegetate now. There's nothing else to do. No, this is like hell. Cut it. You need to remember, like, no, the shaman said, no, this is like the opposite I have to do. Like, punch yourself, wake up and say, no, I don't accept this to become like this. Go have a cold shower. 5 minutes and then come out and you say, okay, what can I do really? And start, do like this, concentrate, relax internally, relax the mind first, and then say, okay, what can I do? Maybe to paint, maybe to make something more constructive.
Yeah.
Make a puzzle.
Yeah.
Call your friends and start having like a more esoteric conversation, like for things like for personal development. I don't know, watch Eckhart Tolle, read a book, make an online meeting with your friends to talk about these things that are more real, you know, things like that. And
Fantastic.
Then when you do this, do push-ups after for 10 minutes also. And then if you do all this, then watch also TV for 1 hour. Okay.
To reward yourself.
Yes, like to balance, to not go crazy, uh-huh. on the other side, like to not be obsessed.
Yeah. Yes. Is it, was, I saw, correct me if I'm wrong, that during this week you have opened the doors of the school to, for anyone that wants to,
yes,
to
yes.
participate. Can you just share that so people yes. that want to find out more of what you do, and we can put the link in the comments after
yes.
we finish.
Yes. This week, all the online trainings we do is for free.
Mm-hmm.
We not all, because we have also a specific seminar. This is not for free.
Okay.
But we do 3 times per week yoga. Actually, mm-hmm. we're starting this now from this week.
Mm-hmm.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Okay.
This will be for 1 up to 3 months, depending on how this will escalate the condition with the virus. We do 1 hour, 10 a.m. in the morning, Romanian time or Greek time,
mm-hmm.
like Eastern European time. So for UK would be 8 in the morning, for Central Europe 9, and from Eastern Europe 10.
Yeah.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday. We do yoga for 1 hour.
Mm-hmm.
We just finished today the first lesson. And 3 times per week also, which is Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday in the afternoon,
mm-hmm.
we do psychoenergetic techniques, the revision, and the lucid dreaming
okay.
techniques. So for this week, all this is for free. I have posted in the Facebook the links. We will post it also after that.
Yeah.
So you can just, using the Zoom program, you can just click and enter and participate.
Mm-hmm.
After this week, if you want to continue, you have to subscribe for the 3 evening practices to the WOW Academy. And plus there you have this seminars and talk about personal power. I give 2 webinars per month.
Mm-hmm.
And also one of these 2 is about our relationships through the knowledge, spiritual knowledge of Tantra. This included in the WOW Academy. So after this week, if you want to continue, you have to subscribe. And the yoga training, also after this week, you have to subscribe, but it's like 20 euros per month
mm-hmm.
to have 3 times per week for 1 hour.
Mm-hmm.
And also, yes, I communicate also with the people if they ask me questions about what to do. So also this is included in this communication and these practices. And for this week is for free. So if somebody wants to tonight at 7 p.m. Eastern European time, 5 p.m. UK, and 6 p.m.
Central European.
Europe, mm-hmm. we have lucid dreaming practice. Mm-hmm. We are talking about our etheric body, the subconscious mind, and all this. We are doing training, like exercise. It's
a kind of
meditation. Yeah, so this will help you very much to have the flow of vital energy going. It's the best thing you can do to remain healthy.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. And I want to thank you very much for your time, for sharing this incredible wisdom of yours, which, you know, I often say that you are the wisest person that I have the pleasure to know in person. And you... No, I mean it. And you were, and I'm just sharing a bit of my own story now for people that maybe don't know about how we know each other, that we used to be best friends back in the university a long, long time ago when we were studying dentistry. And I saw you changing your life's path and following your purpose from getting to become a dentist towards the spirituality and the shamanism, and you You were one of the biggest influences in my life's, oops, I'm starting to, in my own life's path. And I'm always grateful for that, my brother. Thank you very much.
This was intended,
Of
even if
course
you
it
didn't
is.
know it.
Of course it is. Any parting words, Alexander?
First of all, I want to tell you that I love you also too very much. You are really my best friend, one of my
Thank
best
you.
friends. I love you very much. And in these moments, this is for everyone, like the most important for you is this people that you have this relationship like a brother and sister. You have to not lose this. This is the most important. To not feel fear, to feel that we are all in the same boat. And this unity can help you to pass through anything. And yes, maybe you have two, three very close people, but really know that there are other people like you out there, like us, who are very open and who see really everyone like brother and sister. This is why we are trying to help everyone, not because we are like have to help somebody, because we see that the people around us are like ourselves. They are like the most intimate things that life gives us is the people around us. So to try to understand this, that now is the worst thing to isolate and to start expressing negativity and going crazy and start arguing and fighting to see that other people are your enemies, like we see in these films with zombies and stuff like that. The other people are not zombies contaminated and you have to protect yourself. This, like, if something like this takes over you, you are finished. No, the other people are you, actually. And only unity can help you. Even if you get sick, even if you die, the worst thing to happen to you is to die having fear in your heart. I mean, if you would die in peace, it's perfect. So don't be afraid. First of all, you will not die because, as you mentioned, Ike, before, many more people die from other things every day than coronavirus. And
yeah.
We don't know this, but it's the truth. Yes. One person dies for coronavirus, and in the same day, 10 people die from other things. So what to do? To kill ourselves? No. Take the measurements, put the gloves, put the mask, do whatever the government says. Like, take care of not, I mean, sneeze in the face of somebody to not, you know, go in contact, to clean yourself and all this, but without fear, because the biggest possibility is that you will not even get sick at all. And even if you get sick from coronavirus, you are not going to die, except if you have some terrible weakness. If you are in this position, you have to
stay
do something
home.
Now
yeah.
To stay home and take care of, like, change, like, work seriously with yourself and
sure.
ask sure. for help in this moment. And there are people to help you always. So don't panic. There is nothing to be afraid of. And you have all the opportunities to be like Bruce Lee in the hospital, who was isolated there and he actually did great things. And if you find yourself you cannot do this, call somebody. Call Aggie or call me to help you.
Absolutely. Message us on Facebook. We're always available to support and help in
yes.
any way we can.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's it.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. It's been a fascinating conversation, and I hope that people who watched it, and I will actually post it on the podcast as well in a couple of days for people to be able to listen to it. I hope it has given value and a sense of hope and encouragement.
Yes. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay positive, and everything will go well.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, my friend and brother.
Namaste. Thank you.
Namaste.
See you soon. Bye.
See you soon.
Bye to everybody who watched.
Bye.
Bye.